The 100 days trend is one of the biggest trends we've ever seen in the Minecraft community. After being popularized by Luke the Notable, many YouTubers saw the potential of this trend to grow their channels. Even one of the biggest YouTubers on the platform right now, MrBeast, made a 100 days in Minecraft video. And with any trend that gets this big, it's no surprise that there will be a few people who will try to leech onto it without actually bringing any substance to the platform. And it's because of this, we should direct our attention to the people who are faking 100 days Minecraft videos. Sure, Luke the Notable may have tried to trademark the 100 days trend, which was its own issue, but it has since been resolved. What has not been resolved is the fact that YouTubers are getting away with blatantly fake 100 days videos and just using the trend as a cash grab and nothing more. So let's look at some of these dishonest YouTubers. And you know, we might name drop a few people, and it's purely so you can observe the channels for yourself. I am not here to endorse any toxicity or quote unquote cancelling on this video's behalf. Let's get into this. To give some context for anyone who doesn't know about 100 days, the 100 days in Minecraft trend is essentially playing a single world of Minecraft for 100 in-game days, typically on hardcore mode or with some other variation or twist to make the video unique. Making one of these videos is not difficult, but definitely time-consuming, as 100 in-game days is roughly 33 hours in real life. You would have to record up to 33 hours of footage for a single video. And mind you, these videos are usually edited down to about 20 to 30 minutes with added commentary, transitions, and any other effects that a creator might want to add. Some YouTubers may even rely on replay mod footage to add some cinematic flair to their 100 days videos, which makes the elapsed time for editing even longer. Now, I asked one of my friends how long it took for him to make his 100 days videos, and it came down to about 70 hours worth of production time. Some of the more established creators in the community might be faster at making these videos, but I think 70 hours is a good baseline. Keep this number in mind because it's good context for when we look at how these YouTubers might possibly be faking their videos. So we've covered a lot of details about 100 day Minecraft videos, and they require tens of hours of work. Knowing this, you can definitely tease out the creators that are genuinely making these videos. For instance, one of my favorite creators, Kalani, makes 100 days videos roughly once a month. It makes sense because making 100 days videos takes a long time, and factoring in having a good balance between life and YouTube, the staggered uploads show this. And obviously, another prime example is Luke the Notable, because again, he puts a lot of time and effort into his content and has an active life outside of YouTube, which is therefore shown by his sparse upload schedule. The main point is, genuine 100 days YouTubers don't upload often, as making 100 days videos takes a lot of time. Now let's look at some YouTubers who have really high rates of consistency, and we should honestly be a bit suspicious of them. For example, YouTubers Jerome ASF and Ryguy Rocky are uploading these 100 days videos at a really fast pace, averaging about 3 to 4 days between their videos. They also have insanely high amounts of subscribers, so they could devastate my channel if they pulled their fans against me, so let's hope that doesn't happen. Now, I don't know about you, but I don't think these YouTubers have the insane productivity to keep up with such a schedule. We can factor in them having some paid editors on the side to help streamline the content creation, and even if they have very little life outside of YouTube, we still don't even get close to the consistency that these YouTubers have with 100 days. Now, just to double down on what I'm saying, as you can see here, Jerome has uploaded 11 videos in the past 5 days. Two of those videos are Minecraft 100 days, and they were uploaded 4 days apart from each other. 11 videos in 5 days is an incredible amount of content, and it leaves little to no time for playing Minecraft for a complete 100 days. If we zoom out and look at the past 2 weeks, he has uploaded 5 100-day videos. This is out of 32 videos in total that he uploaded in the past 2 weeks. Okay, that's a bit sus. But what about the other guy I mentioned, Ryguy Rocky? Well, he isn't as frequent of an uploader as Jerome, but he has made 8 100-day videos in the past month. While even more popular 100-day YouTubers can barely get one upload out every 3 weeks, these YouTubers are dropping content at an impossibly fast rate. I'd like to think that these YouTubers are legit, but seriously, some of the best YouTubers on the platform cannot honestly come close to this consistency. It's just not realistic. So what exactly is going on? Well, the most sound conclusion we can make is that they are not playing for the full 100 in-game days. Instead, they record a few hours of footage and splice it in a way that makes it look like they've played 100 days. It's not that difficult to do, and anyone out there who edits videos or has any experience with editing could probably agree with me. Now, let's take a quick look at Jerome's comment section on one of his 100 days videos. This one is titled, "I survived 100 days in a dragon world in Minecraft." Now, this was the newest comment I found on the video. It said, "Wow, it's really cool how it went from day 15 to day 25 and all of Jerome's stats are exactly the same." Now, okay, that's pretty funny, but the second comment I've got I think is even better. "I love how in 3 minutes and 30 seconds, 25 days passed the end days from 85 to 100. Totally not a staged video." I think this commenter meant to say 15 days, because 100 minus 85 is 50. They're proving my point, okay? In fact, I really want to see this. Come on, let's go check out this video. I want to see how Jerome does it, okay? I want to see the master at work and how he tricks his fans. Let's go. All right, we're watching now. It's day 85. Okay, day 85. What's the timestamp? 21 minutes and 28 seconds. Apparently, 3 minutes later, we should be seeing some interesting stuff. So I'm going to speed this up to about 2. And we're going to see how long does it take for him to get from day 85 to day 100, right? Oh, it's day 100. It's day 100. Hold up. It just went past me. Okay, wait. We saw the whole footage. I showed all of it because I wanted to just prove. Day 100? Really? He really just went from. If you're faking videos, okay, you can't just go, "Oh yes, it's day 1, I'm chopping a tree. Oh guys, it's day 34, I'm mining diamonds." No, that's, you can't do that. You just can't skip that much time, okay? If you're going to fake your 100 days videos, at least go from like day 1 to day 5 to day 10, okay? You don't need to include all the days, but you don't need to skip all of them too. You can't just skip the days because you didn't record them. No. You gotta put in the effort, man. I only chose to focus on these two YouTubers, or mainly Jerome and also Ryguy Rocky, because they were the easiest YouTubers to find that exemplified my point. 100 days videos can be easily faked, and while it's not certain that either of these YouTubers are faking their content, it's definitely questionable. But hey, if they make entertaining videos and they have a rapid upload schedule, then I guess it benefits their audience in some way. I just like to watch content that has some authenticity behind it, and I think many of the people watching can agree. I mean, that's why you're watching and you've made it this far, is because you agree with me that these fake Minecraft YouTubers are not so much something that we want in the community. But we can go one step further. There are some 100 days YouTubers who are not just faking their content, but are actually stealing content from other YouTubers. Now, these content thieves are in a very unique category and have only come to my attention recently. I am talking about Hindi translation channels, which by that alone doesn't even sound related to 100 days, but let me explain. There are YouTube channels which are reposting 100 days videos, but they remove the original audio and replace it with their own Hindi narration. They then upload these modified videos as if it were their own content. Now, the scary thing is, if you are a 100 days content creator and you've made it to the recommended tab, there is a chance someone has taken your video and then re-uploaded it with Hindi narration, removing all of your original commentary. Granted, some of these channels put quote-unquote credit in the description, but they are still reposting your content and putting nowhere near the amount of effort that the original creator did. They even reuse the thumbnails from the 100 days videos they steal. Now, your stance on this may vary. Personally, I'll only endorse YouTubers who put a genuine effort into what they upload. Other people might not care as much about being a genuine creator, and instead just want to exist on the platform for the ad revenue. YouTube doesn't even mind if you fake these 100 days videos. As long as they are captivating, are monetizable, and can keep people on the platform for longer, they're not even going to care. We cannot do anything about this issue, and you'd be hard-pressed by some to even call this an issue. But at the very least, I think it's fair to make this video and talk about how some YouTubers treat this platform, and how they treat the Minecraft 100 days trend, as well as other trends that may come along in the future. Luke the Notable popularized and still upholds the trend to this day, encouraging smaller creators to make their own 100 days videos. And when he made an attempt to trademark 100 days, we can have a sense of agreement in why he did so after looking at what we've seen. It wasn't meant solely to stamp out smaller creators on the platform, it was more so a response to people abusing this trend without adding any effort on their part. So in the end, you should be careful before you become an active supporter of someone who thrives off stolen content, or fakes videos for whatever reason. They may be fun to watch, but there are certainly more genuine creators out there who are worth your time. Keep that in mind, and thank you for watching.